Right, in the previous class, what all did we do? We had done all the defects which were occurring in solids, either due to shifting of the cations, shifting of the anions, or due to impurities which we are introducing from outside. Now, we also said that any crystal behaves as a perfect crystal only at zero Kelvin. Right? If the temperature is raised, as a result of that, the electrons or the points, they gain energy and they start moving from one place to another, as a result of which the solids become defected crystals, and one major consequence of that was that they start conducting electricity. Now, today's topic is the last topic of this chapter, in which we are going to study electric properties and magnetic properties of solids. Depending upon the electric properties, we classify the solids into three. The first one which is known as conductors, the second one insulators, and the third one is semiconductors, right? The conductors, they conduct electricity, and their conductivity is of the order of 10 raised to power 4 to 10 raised to power 7 ohms, 7 ohms per meter. Okay? So this is going to be 10 raised to power 4 to 10 raised to power 7 per ohm per meter. This is going to be the conductivity of conductors. You have to remember one thing, that the conductors, they do not conduct electricity in the solid state. That is because they do not have any free electrons or any free ions. They only conduct electricity in the aqueous state or in the molten state. Aqueous state and in the molten state, because in the aqueous state the ions are free to move, and in the molten state also the ions, they become loose and they can move easily. Therefore, conductors will conduct electricity only in the aqueous and the molten state, although they have a very high you can say value of conductivity. Okay, then insulators, they do not conduct electricity at all, because their conductivity is very less. It is of the order of 10 raised to power minus 20 to 10 raised to power minus 10 per ohm per meter. Examples, we have wood, plastics, all these, they are said to be insulators, even rubber. Okay, then we come to semiconductors. Semiconductors, they come in between conductors and insulators. They have conductivity of the order of 10 raised to power 10 raised to power minus 6 to 10 raised to power 4 per ohm per meter. This is going to be the conductivity of semiconductors. We will discuss conductors and semiconductors in detail. So let's go on to the first one, which is conductors. The conductors are of the following two types. The first one is known as metallic conductors or electronic conductors. So the name itself suggests that all metals, they are going to come under this category. They conduct electricity without undergoing conductors, they conduct electricity without undergoing any chemical change. So no chemical change that is going to take place over here when the metals, they conduct electricity. The electricity in this case, conducted by movement of electrons. Okay, so when the electrons are going to move, we know that the current, it flows in the opposite direction than the movement of electrons. So the metals, they are going to conduct electricity by movement of electrons. Another thing which is important over here, that is, in this case, in metallic or electronic conductors, the conductivity decreases. The conductivity decreases with increase in temperature. Why this happens? This we will do in the conduction band theory. So these are the first kind of conductors, metallic or electronic conductors. The second kind of conductors which we have, they are known as electrolytic or ionic conductors. Electrolytic or ionic conductors. Now in this case, whenever electricity has to be conducted, there is going to be some chemical change taking place. Right? So there is certain, that means that the compounds, they are first converted into ions, and then these ions, they start conducting electricity. So there is a chemical change which is taking place over here. Now, in this case, the electricity is conducted by movement of ions. By movement of ions. But ionic conductors, they will conduct electricity only in the aqueous state or in the molten state. As for example, if we are taking solid NaCl, solid NaCl is not going to conduct electricity, but when we take the molten form of NaCl, it will conduct electricity. And also if we are taking NaCl in aqueous form, that is we are dissolving it in water, even then it is conducting electricity. Okay, so these are the two type of conductors. Then we come to, in this case, electrolytic conductors, when we are looking at the difference, so metallic, electricity is conducted by electrons, and in electrolytic, it is conducted by ions. When we are talking of the second type of conductors, which we are going to talk over here, or we can say those solids which conduct electricity to a certain extent, they are known as semiconductors. So, we are saying that semiconductors. Now, what are semiconductors? Semiconductors, basically they are insulators in normal form, but they can be converted into conductors. Although they do not conduct electricity in a similar manner as conductors do, unki conductivity jo hai, that is less, that is of the order of only 10 raised to power minus 6 to 10 raised to power 4. Per ohm per meter. Okay, so they are basically insulators. They conduct electricity either if the temperature is raised or if we introduce certain impurities from outside. Okay, if the temperature is raised, then in that such semiconductors, they are known as intrinsic semiconductors. In over here means that there is no impurity which is added from outside. There are certain changes which are taking place inside the conductor only or inside the solid only, therefore transforming it into a semiconductor. So that is why we call them as intrinsic. The elements of group 14, they behave as good intrinsic semiconductors. As an example which we can take over here is that of silicon. Now we know over here that in silicon, every silicon atom is tetrahedrally attached to four other silicon atoms. So if we are making another layer over here, right? So if you're taking this silicon is attached to four other silicons. Okay? So they are attached tetrahedrally to four other silicons. अब चार सिलिकॉन के साथ वो बाउंड है. जब हम टेम्परेचर इंक्रीज करते हैं तो इट सो हैपेंस कि बॉन्ड्स जो इसके बीच के हैं दे माइट ब्रेक. ओके, नाउ इफ द बॉन्ड्स ओवर हियर आर ब्रेकिंग दे लीव द बॉन्ड, एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ व्हिच व्हाट दे डू इज दे क्रिएट अ वैकेंसी और होल ओवर हियर व्हिच इज नोन एज अ पॉजिटिव होल. So in this case, there are two kinds of movements which are taking place. One is the movement of the electron and the other is the movement of the positive hole. Right? Now the electrons, they keep moving in the interstitial sites. So if the electron has shifted from here, it will move from one interstitial site to the other. Okay? Whereas the hole, that will move from bond to bond. Okay, so silicon, it starts conducting electricity in two manners over here. One by the movement of electrons and other by the movement of positive holes. By the movement of electrons, ka matlab kya hua? The electricity will pass in an opposite direction than the movement of the electrons. Or positive holes ka matlab hua ki electricity, it flows in the same direction as that of the movement of the positive hole. A similar kind can also be seen in geranium. Geranium also basically it has the same kind of arrangement, and in this also whenever energy is supplied to the crystal, the bonds break, the electrons move, creating a vacancy which is known as positive hole. The electrons move in the interstitial sites, whereas the positive holes, they keep moving through the bonds. So these are examples of, this is an example of intrinsic type of semiconductor. Okay, the second type of semiconductor which we have, that is extrinsic type of semiconductor. X means we are now introducing an impurity from outside, and the process of introducing this impurity, that is known as doping. Okay, now in extrinsic there are two types of, you can say there are two types of impurities which we are going to introduce. So according to that, we classify the extrinsic semiconductors into two. The first one N-type semiconductor. Now N-type semiconductor may, we are going to introduce impurity with higher valency than the solid in the or the the crystal. So impurity is with higher valency. For example, if we are introducing an impurity in group 14, so in this case, for group 14, if we are introducing an impurity, the impurity which will be added is a pentavalent impurity, right? So group 14 is tetravalent. Higher valency or higher valency impurity has to be introduced. So we are introducing pentavalent impurity over here. For example, हम group 14 को group 15 के साथ dope करते हैं. हम group 14 को group 15 के साथ dope करते हैं. ठीक है? So अब जब हम इसमें doping कर रहे हैं, group 15 को दे रहे हैं, तो हम let's say हमारा किस तरह से structure यहाँ पे बन रहा है, we have belongs to group 14. Group 15 we can put nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic. So if we are putting an impurity of arsenic over here, so in this case one of the geraniums from here they are going, that is going to be substituted by arsenic, right? So what are we saying over here? This is substituted by arsenic. अब आर्सेनिक के साथ अगर ये सब्स्टिट्यूट हो गया यहाँ पे, तो एक इलेक्ट्रॉन जो है वो फ्री रह जाएगा. आर्सेनिक के पास 5 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स हैं वैलेंस शेल में, 4 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स दे आर फॉर्मिंग बॉन्ड्स ओवर हियर एंड 1 इलेक्ट्रॉन दैट इज लेफ्ट फ्री. दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर कंडक्शन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी इन एन टाइप सेमीकंडक्टर्स. ओके, सो एन ओवर हियर, that is, what is that? That is signifying negative charge, and that is the concentration of the electrons which are formed when group 14 is doped with group 15, right? The other type of semiconductors which we have, that is p-type semiconductors. We have p-type semiconductors. In case of p-type semiconductors, impurity with lower valency is introduced. We are doping it with group 13. Okay, so in a similar manner, so we have germanium over here. Okay? So in this case, we are going to introduce an impurity of group 13. So group 13 ka hum yahan pe kya le sakte hain? We can take indium. Okay? So we are introducing indium over here. Now indium ke saath kya hoga? It will form three bonds and
and a vacancy is created over here in the form of positive holes. These positive holes, they start moving, as a result of which this starts conducting electricity. So because it has positive charge, the P over here signifies the concentration of the positive charge. Now in metallic conductors, we discussed, or we said that with increase in temperature, the conductivity, that is going to decrease. But over here, jab temperature increase hota hai, toh conductivity bhi increase ho jati hai. Aur ye hum kiske basis pe explain karenge? Isko hum explain karte hai on the basis of conduction band theory. Right? So, we are going to discuss over here conduction band theory. Conduction band theory explains to us the effect of temperature on various kinds of solids. Right? Temperature ka jo effect hota hai, usko explain karta hai. Now, conduction band theory ka matlab kya hua? We know that electrons, they are present in the valence shells, right? And whenever atomic orbitals overlap, they form molecular orbitals. This you have done in class 11. So when they have made molecular orbitals, these many molecular orbitals, they possess similar energy. And as a result of which, they form bands. These bands are known as what? They are known as valence bands. So valence bands are bands in which the electrons are present in the valence shell. Okay, now any electron, if it jumps from the valence band to another band which is known as the conduction band, only then it is going to conduct electricity. Basically, when energy is provided to the electrons leave their valence band and they are tossed from the valence band to the conduction band, which results in conduction of electricity. Now, sometimes it happens, it so happens that there is certain energy gap between the valence band and the conduction band, as in the case of semiconductors and insulators, of course, and in certain, you can say, metals, the valence band and the conduction band, they are overlapping with each other and there is no energy gap. The picture which we are going to show over here, the diagram which we are going to show over here, is going to make it more clear. Okay, so what are we saying? If this is the energy, we have conduction band which is at a higher energy, right? And we have a valence band which is at a lower energy. If the conduction band and the valence band, they overlap each other, then this is a metallic conductor. When the valence band and conduction band, they overlap each other, so this forms a metallic conductor. Now electrons automatically, they will keep on, as if when the potential difference is applied, automatically the electrons will move from the valence band to the conduction band. ठीक है ना? जैसे potential difference apply करेंगे, वैसे ही valence band से conduction band की तरफ को electrons move करने लग जाते हैं and they start conducting electricity. जब temperature increase होता है, तो the electrons, they get more energy and they even might leave the conduction band, as a result of which, with increase in temperature, the conductivity of the metallic conductors decreases. Clear? Now, when we're talking of semiconductors, in case of semiconductors, there is a small difference between the valence band and the conduction band. And this difference, this is a no electron zone. So this is also known as forbidden zone. This is also known as forbidden zone. Now when energy is given to the electrons, temperature increase kara jata hai, to electrons gain karte hai energy and they are tossed from the valence band to the conduction band. They are tossed from the valence band to the conduction band, and this area is forbidden for electrons. So this is known as the forbidden zone. So temperature increase kiya, valence band se conduction band mein chale gaye and they start conducting electricity. But jab hum insulators dekhte hain, इंसुलेटर्स में बहुत ज्यादा गैप है या विड्थ जो है फॉरबिडन जोन की वो बहुत ज्यादा हमें नजर आ रही है. तो अगर हम टेम्परेचर इंक्रीज भी कर दें तो दे विल नॉट बी एबल टू जंप फ्रॉम द वैलेंस बैंड टू द कंडक्शन बैंड. ओके, सो दिस इज व्हाट कंडक्शन बैंड थ्योरी इज. राइट, द नेक्स्ट वी गो ऑन टू द मेटालिक सॉरी द मैग्नेटिक प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ सॉलिड्स. Magnetic properties of solids. Depending upon how a solid behaves in a magnetic field, we classify the solids into the following. The first one diamagnetic. What are diamagnetic? Diamagnetic solids are those which are repelled by the magnetic field.
So, result
resultant resultant magnetic moment can be calculated by the formula Nn+2, right? Where N is equal to number of unpaired electrons. Okay? Ions like Fe3 positive, Cr3 positive, they behave as paramagnetic substances. Okay? Whereas if you are considering water, calculate the number of electrons in water. We have 2 of hydrogen and we have how many of oxygen? 8 of oxygen. So in total 10 electrons. So diamagnetic, water is going to be diamagnetic in nature. Is it clear? So this is how we categorize diamagnetic and paramagnetic. The third type of we have is एंटीफेरोमैग्नेटिक. एंटीफेरोमैग्नेटिक में जो ये डोमेन्स होते हैं ये पैरेलल और एंटी पैरेलल डायरेक्शंस में अलाइन रहते हैं इन अ फिक्स्ड नंबर और इन द सेम नंबर, राइट. अगर एक पैरेलल है तो दूसरा एंटी पैरेलल है इन अ इन दिस मैनर. सो एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ व्हिच तो जो यहाँ पे मैग्नेटिक नेट मैग्नेटिक मोमेंट होता है वो जीरो हो जाता है एंड एंटी फेरोमैग्नेटिक सब्सटेंसेस जो है they behave as non-magnets. Example of anti-ferromagnetic substances we can take over here is MnO, N2O3, Mn2O3, Mn3O4. So oxides of magnesium, manganese, they behave as anti-ferromagnetic substances.
Solve those questions, and then if you have any doubt, you can ask.